फ्रेंड्स, वी मस्ट फील हैप्पी और इट्स ए साइन ऑफ हैप्पीनेस दैट द लास्ट स्टूडेंट्स दे आर फाइलिंग द पब्लिक इंटरेस्ट लिटिगेशंस एज ए लॉ स्टूडेंट्स. नॉर्मली द लास्ट स्टूडेंट्स एज स्टूडेंट्स वी मे बी हेजिटेंट बिकॉज the judge may feel whatever we write, what we write, the language and tenor may not be proper. The judge may take in the other side. Very recently, one of the law students imposed a fine of ₹20,000 for filing a frivolous public interest litigation like that. You feel, but still better be emboldened and try to take out the public issues, the interest, public interest issues. To the notice of the Honorable Court. Of course, if not today, after 2 or 3 years as regular advocates, we have to do the same. The main purpose of the advocates is that only. So, it is a remedial right, Article 32 of the Constitution of India and 226 before the High Court. They are the rights to remedies. They are the remedial rights. We can file a public interest litigation. We have to appreciate the students for filing the public interest litigation. In Rajasthan, this thing happened. So I will read out the names of these people because it is difficult to spell their names properly. So two law students by names Himakshi Aleria, Himakshi Alaria or Aleria, and Harsh Kumar. This man is good, Harsh Kumar. They filed a public interest litigation in the Rajasthan High Court, pointing out that the Food Corporation of India, that means the center, Food Corporation of India is not releasing sufficient quantity of food grains to the needy people. Of course, they have added the authorities of National Disaster Management Authority also. These officials, both of them, they are not giving the so-called ration or sufficient quantity of food grains to the needy people, right? How it has come? So normally, during this pandemic season, every state is trying its best to give or to provide the so-called ration to the poor and needy people, right? We have to appreciate the states. They are doing their best. But still, there are certain lacunas. There may be certain lacunas. We can't get everything foolproof, of course. It is the duty of the civilians to bring out the defects. Then only the government will rectify. Otherwise, government will think everything is fine. Right. Now these students, they state that they brought it to the notice of the High Court that FCI is not giving sufficient quantity of the food grains to the destitutes. This is important. To the destitutes and also the underprivileged. So the number raised exponentially after the data collection of 2013. Here the main problem, right? So the government, the state government Rajasthan or the FCA, they state that they have given or they have provided 2.23 metric tons of food grains to the people. The beneficiaries are 4.46 crore in number, of course. This is based on the 2011 census, and of course the data collection of 2013 is also somewhat added, but later so many people were added. Another pathetic story is that the people who are stranded elsewhere, they do not get the ration. Now, even though now they come here, they can't get the ration because the period is over. So the person who are not having ration cards and the destitutes, all these persons, they are not getting the ration or the food sufficient quantity of food grains from the FCI, right? So what are who are these people? Number one, the migrant laborers who returned from the other places. Number one, daily wage earners or daily wage workers. Then people excluded from social security pension. Yes, definitely, older people, some people, they are having a card, they will hit it. But there are certain people who are excluded from the social security pension. For example, you have your electricity consumption. If it exceeds so and so units, your card is gone. So what about them? Definitely they are poor. The people who are excluded from the social security pensions. And those who are not covered under the Food Security Act, so National Food Security Act, because people are there, definitely the beggars, so many people they are there. So they are the important contributors to the change of demography in the state, definitely. So as per the records, 4.46 crores beneficiaries are there, but as per these people, they say the demography shows that they are about 5 crores. That means there's a difference of 54 lakhs people who are not supplied with the so-called food grains. They should also be supplied with the food grains. So this is definitely the record maintained, or the explanation given by these people clearly establishes that there is shortage of supply to 54 lakhs of people. They are able to establish. Of course, now the Rajasthan High Court, of course, I think it may be satisfied, and they posted the matter to July 13th. While directing the center and the so-called authorities like NDMA, FCA, to take urgent action if the contention or if the assertion of the petitioners was found to be correct. They have to follow the guideline. That means they have to supply the food grains. Already the country, FCA, if for that matter the FCA, that they are boasting that we are having sufficient quantity of the food grains here. But I don't know why they are not able to be disbursed to the needy, and particularly during this pandemic season, they have to be distributed freely, liberally. Of course, the government has got certain, definitely they have got their own limitations, because tomorrow they will be audited also. But anyway, they have to ascertain the correct number. They have to ascertain the number of people who are destitute, who do not have any other means of livelihood, and who are migrant laborers, who have come very recently from other states, who do not have the so-called ration card, who are devoid of the ration cards. All these things they have to take into consideration, and they have to come to the help of the poor, needy people. Otherwise, what is the purpose of storing so much of food grains in the godowns of the FCA? Nothing but they will be damaged, or the rats will take them away, and unnecessarily they have to be thrown out. That's the result. So better the central government or national disaster. The purpose of NDM is that only. So during these emergency conditions, they have got umpteen powers, enormous powers. They can definitely take out the food grains from the godowns, and they can supply to the poor and needy people. Of course, they should not mismanage things. But anyway, since there's a direction from the High Court, they can do this. Anyway, we have to actually say kudos to the law students to make an in their efforts to vent out the grievance of the poor and needy people. And as advocates, we have to do that. Previously, the advocates used to actually speak out, or they used to climb out for the protection of the rights of the people. Yes, they struggled for the rights of the people. At least nowadays, the changing of the scenario is coming. Definitely, we have to appreciate their activities. And as students, we also follow them better. You filing a public interest litigation, you need not have any specific pro forma. If you send just a letter, it will be taken as a public interest litigation. Of course, mind you that the cause should be in the general interest, not for your personal interest. So if you do that, definitely you will be fined. Already I made a video on the student who was imposed a fine of 20,000. Anyway, we have to congratulate these two students coming out with a real cause. Anyway, you also try to file some personal public interest litigations. Thank you.